So hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to the session of PIB 24/7. I am Manish Mishra and guys, in today's session I will bring to you five more important questions from the PIB news. So let's start karte hain with the session, but before we begin, if you are new here, and so do subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon, and also you can join this Telegram group for daily quizzes and updated information about the daily sessions. Alright, so let's begin with the question number one. Recently, second world economic outlook for the month of October 2020 has been released by the International Monetary Fund, IMF. So we all know guys, world economic outlook jo hai wo saal mein do baar nikali jati hai. It has been released twice every year by IMF to predict global economic development. So with respect to the outlook, we have to identify the incorrect statement. Okay, so let's discuss the key highlights of the report. Isme bahut lambi chaudi report thi, so we don't have to mug up the complete report, just these are the key highlights. You have to remember this only, right? So global growth will be contracted by 4.4% in the year 2020 as predicted by this outlook. Jo global growth hai wo 4.4% contract ho jayega, matlab it will be grow by -4.4%. okay, -4.4%, while in 2021 global growth will show some positive signs and will grow at the rate of 5.2% in the near term, while for the medium term it will grow gradually by 3.5%. okay, so remember this, 5.2% for the near term, while for the medium term it is 3.5%. Around 90 million people will fall below the income threshold of $1.90 a day, which is the income threshold for the extreme poverty. The extreme poverty ka income threshold of the World Bank. So according to this report, 90 million people aise honge that will fall below this income threshold. And school closures can be a setback for human capital development. This is obvious guys, because agar school band honge then obviously it will affect the development of human capital. And for India, for the year 2020 the GDP growth projected is -10.3%, which means our GDP will be contracted by 10.3%, while for the 2021 it has been projected that our GDP will grow by 8.8%. But is it a good news for us? It is. Is it enough for the revival of our GDP? No guys, let me explain you this with an example. Let us say in 2019 our GDP value was ₹100, hamari jo total GDP thi wo kitne ki thi, 100 rupaye ki thi. Then in 2020 a contraction occur of approximately 10%. Okay, let us say it is 10%. So a contraction occur, which means our in 2020 the value of our GDP will be how much? ₹90. Okay, while in 2021 if our GDP grows by 8.8%, let us say it be 9%, maan lete hain kitna hai, 9% hai, then 90 ka 9% will be 8.1, which means the value of GDP will be how much? 98.1. so in 2019 it was 100, while in 2021 as per these projections it will be 98.1. so is it enough for us? No, because 2 saal pehle jiski value 100 thi, aaj uski 98.1 hai, jisko at least 100 se upar to hona hi chahiye tha. Okay, so this is not enough for us, we have to rise more taki hum aur acche se revive kar sake hamari economy ko. All right, so this was about this outlook guys. So let's move on to the question. Now we have to identify the incorrect statements. According to the report, global growth will contract by 4.4% in the year 2020. Yes, this is absolutely correct. And around 90 million people will fall below the income threshold of $1.90 a day. Yes, this is also correct. And guys, remember this threshold. It might be asked in your exam that what is the extreme poverty threshold of the World Bank for a day. So this is $1.90 a day. And India's GDP growth will grow at 8.8% in the year 2020. But this is also correct, which means none is incorrect should be the correct answer, because we have to identify the incorrect statements. Okay, so option D here will be the correct answer. And now let's come to the question number two. Can you tell me who is the chief of IMF? Write down in the comments. So question number two is about the flash flood guidance service, which is first of its kind service launched by IMD, India Meteorological Department. So it was launched by IMD for South Asian nations to provide guidance for flash floods. Which of the following is not one of the nations for which this service was launched? So ye flash flood guidance service hai, it will provide guidance in the case of flash flood, and it will also provide the warning system in the case of flash flood. Agar flash flood aane wala hai to ye warning provide karayega, aur agar aa gaya hai to ye real time availability dega of the equipments which can be used to fight the flash floods. Okay, so this is the news. So India Meteorological Department has commissioned this first of its kind flash flood guidance services for South Asian nations. And which are these nations? Itself India, then Nepal, Bhutan, Bangladesh and Sri Lanka. And remember this thing, that this service has been launched on the lines of 15th World Meteorology Organization Congress that had approved the setting up of flash flood guidance service across the world. Pure duniya mein flash flood guidance services pahunchane ka approval diya gaya tha in the World Meteorology Organization Congress, that the 15th edition. And this flash flood guidance service has been developed by WMO Commission for Hydrology. Okay, WMO Commission, World Meteorological Organization Commission for Hydrology ने इसको डेवलप किया है एंड 15th वर्ल्ड मेट्रोलॉजिकल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन कांग्रेस में अप्रूव किया गया था दैट इट विल बी प्रोवाइडेड टू द होल वर्ल्ड. ओके एंड अ डेडिकेटेड एफएफजीएस सेंटर विल बी एस्टैब्लिश्ड इन न्यू दिल्ली. नई दिल्ली में डेडिकेटेड सेंटर बनाया जाएगा विच इज ऑल्सो द हेडक्वार्टर ऑफ आईएमडी. ऑलराइट एंड दीज आर सम अदर की पॉइंट्स अबाउट दिस सिस्टम गाइस. सो दिस सिस्टम विल प्रोवाइड गाइडेंस फॉर फ्लैश फ्लड्स in the form of threat 6 hours in advance and in the form of risk 24 hours in advance. It is designed to provide the necessary products in real time to support the development of warnings for flash floods. And also it has a resolution of 4 km by 4 km. Matlab 4 km by 4 km ka jo area hoga, usme it will provide guidance and the real time support. Alright. So let's come back to the question. Which of the following is not one of the nations for which this service was launched? So Nepal, Bhutan, Bangladesh, Sri Lanka and itself India. Which means option E, Maldives, will be the correct answer. And now let's come to the question number 3, which is about the recently launched 3 projects by the Prime Minister. So Prime Minister has recently launched 3 projects in Gujarat. One of the project was Kisan Suryodaya Yojana, Farmer Sunrise Scheme. Which of the following statements is are correct regarding the Yojana? Okay, so these are the 3 projects that have been launched by Prime Minister in Gujarat. One is Kisan Suryodaya Yojana. Then we have Pediatric Heart Hospital, which is attached with UN Mehta Institute of Cardiology and Research. And remember this, this is India's largest institute of cardiology and research. Okay, and a ropeway at Girnar, which is now the world's longest. It is the world's longest temple ropeway. This is very important. It is the world's longest temple roadway at Girnar. Okay, so these are the 3 projects guys that have been launched by the Prime Minister. And let's talk about this Kisan Purvodaya Yojana, under which farmers will get solar power. Farmer ko kya diya jayega? Solar powers in 3 phases from 9 a.m. to 5 a.m. to 9 p.m. Okay, farmers will be provided with 3 phases solar power supply from 5 a.m. to 9 p.m. ताकि वो irrigation facilities का properly इस्तेमाल कर सके. Okay, so that they can easily avail the irrigation facilities. And the total cost for this project guys is how much? 3500 crore, total 3500 crore का है. And 66 kilowatt transmission lines with a total length of 3490 circuit kilometers will be established. This is not for important for the exam, but yes, this is for your basic understanding. Alright. Remember this, that the total cost is almost 3500 crore. Farmers will get 3 phase power supply from 5 a.m. to 9 p.m. Okay. And isma kya hoga? Solar power. Matlab solar power se jo bijli aayegi, that will be provided to the farmers. And the scheme has been launched in Gujarat. This is also very important. And these are the districts where this scheme is implemented for this financial year. For the financial year 2020-21, this scheme has been launched in these districts of Gujarat, while for the rest of the district, it will be launched in a phase-wise manner by the year 2022-23. And remember also one more thing, that this scheme is for a period of 3 years, which means up to 2023. Okay. So this was about this news, guys. Let's come back to the question. Which of the following statements is are correct regarding the Yojana? So under this Yojana, farmers will get 3 phase power supply for 12 hours. So guys, was it 12 hours? 5 a.m. to 9 p.m. is it 12 hours? No, it is 16 hours, which means this statement is incorrect. And 3500 crores will be spent under the scheme over a period of 4 years. So is it 4 years? No, it is not 4 years. It is 3 years, which means this statement is also incorrect. Therefore, the correct answer should be what? Option D. Neither 1 nor 2 is correct. And now let's come to the question number 4. So guys, the question number 4 and 5 are based on this report that has been recently released by the Ministry of Tourism. The name is India Tourism Statistics at a Glance 2020, and this report tells us about the facts of facts related to tourism for the year 2019 में टूरिज्म से रिलेटेड जो भी फैक्ट्स हमारे कंट्रीज में, दिस रिपोर्ट टेल्स अस अबाउट दोस फैक्ट्स. ओके सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट सम की फैक्ट्स एंड की हाइलाइट्स. वैसे ये रिपोर्ट बहुत ज्यादा कॉम्प्रिहेंसिव है, बट दैट थिंग यू डोंट हैव टू डू, जस्ट रिमेंबर दीज हाइलाइटेड फैक्ट्स दैट आई एम गोना टू टेल यू. सो नंबर ऑफ फॉरेन टूरिस्ट अराइवल्स इन इंडिया 10.93 मिलियन फॉरेन टूरिस्ट थे जो कि इंडिया में आए थे इन द ईयर 2019. नंबर ऑफ डोमेस्टिक टूरिस्ट विजिट्स टू स्टेट्स और यूटीज 2321.98 मिलियन. मतलब जो डोमेस्टिक टूरिज्म था इंडिया का, एक स्टेट से दूसरे स्टेट कितने लोग गए तो वो कितने थे 2321.98 मिलियन. देन टॉप थ्री सोर्स कंट्रीज फॉर फॉरेन टूरिस्ट अराइवल, कौन से कंट्रीज से सबसे ज्यादा टूरिस्ट हमारे देश में आए? बांग्लादेश, यूएसए एंड यूके. नंबर वन पे इट वॉज बांग्लादेश, देन यूएसए, देन यूके. टॉप थ्री डेस्टिनेशन कंट्रीज फॉर इंडियन नेशनल डिपार्चर्स, हमारे देश के अगर कोई लोग बाहर गए हैं तो वो कौन कौन से देशों में गए हैं? नंबर वन पे इट इज यूएई, नंबर टू सऊदी अरेबिया, नंबर थ्री यूएसए. देन वी हैव डोमेस्टिक टूरिस्ट विजिट्स लिस्ट इन 2019, सबसे ज्यादा डोमेस्टिक टूरिज्म कौन से स्टेट में था? सो एट नंबर वन इट वॉज उत्तर प्रदेश 23.1%. Then we have Tamil Nadu and then at number 3 we have Andhra Pradesh. Okay. And while if you talk about the foreign tourism, so in the terms of foreign tourism, Tamil Nadu was at number 1, 21.9%, then Maharashtra, then at number 3 we have Uttar Pradesh. Alright. And this report also talks about guys India's position in the world. So the share of India in international tourist arrival is just 1.23%. Yani ki jo foreign tourism hai usme India ka share keval aur keval puri duniya ka 1.2% है. India's rank in world tourist arrivals it is 23rd, while in Asian Pacific region India's rank is 8th. Okay, so this is the key highlight of this report. Now let's come to the question number 4 and 5. Ministry of Tourism has released its publication titled India Tourism Statistics at a Glance 2020. So which state is ranked number 1 in domestic tourist visits in 2019? So this state is what guys? Uttar Pradesh. By for the foreign visits, it was Tamil Nadu. Okay. So Uttar Pradesh is the correct answer. Uttar Pradesh Chief Minister is Yogi Adityanath and Governor is Anandiben Patel. In Uttar Pradesh, you will find Dudhwa National Park. You will also find Katarniya Ghat Wildlife Sanctuary. You will find Kishangarh Wildlife Sanctuary and Dudhwa National Park is also the tiger reserve. Okay. And talking more about Uttar Pradesh, so they have recently launched Ayush Kavach app. They have launched U Shore portal for the students. I hope the board is visible to all of you. Then if you remember the state of Young India Child Report, okay, that we have discussed. The state of Young Child India report, Uttar Pradesh was at the second worst place. Okay, Uttar Pradesh was at the second worst place after Bihar. Okay, so these are some basic facts about Uttar Pradesh. And let's talk about question number 5. Which of the following countries is the top source for foreign tourist arrivals in India as per the India Tourism Statistics at a Glance? So this state, this country guys is Bangladesh. Okay, so option B, Bangladesh here will be the correct answer. Bangladesh Prime Minister is Sheikh Hasina. Party is Awami League. Bangladesh Independence Day it is on 26th March. 26th March when Independence Day hota hai. They have recently launched online plasma network which is known as Shoho Jodha. Recently we have conducted exercise Bongo Sagar with Bangladesh, and also we have one more exercise in Bangladesh which is known as Sampriti. Okay, so these are some basic information. And a new trade route has recently been started between Bangladesh and India. From where to where? From Sonamura in Tripura to Dorkandi. Sonamura in Tripura to Dorkandi in Bangladesh. Okay, so these are some basic information about Bangladesh. Option B, Bangladesh is the correct answer here. Okay guys, so that's it for the session. I hope aapko ye session acha laga and there are no doubts. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Milte hain kal ke session mein. Goodbye, take care and God bless.